Hi everyone, in this new After Effects tutorial we're going to see how to create this super cool dynamic grid with the vertical and horizontal axis moving independently from each other. From there we're going to see how to create variation and offset in the grid, how to insert distorted elements and tracked elements. But before starting, a big thanks to Motion Array for sponsoring this tutorial, and some cool stuff about them later in the video. Start with a vertical line that will be our visual guide. Align it to the center, change the color and rename it Guide X1. Create a new object and rename also that X1. Then parent the stroke to the null, select them both and duplicate them for the number of columns you want in your composition plus 1. Move the first null all to the left and the last one all to the right. And then spread all the other along the comp to create your grid vertical guides. Now we can hide our strokes since they are controlled by the nulls object and we don't need them at the moment. Now, with a different stroke color, let's repeat the process for the horizontal strokes. So, again, rename it. This time with the Y, create a null, parent it, rename also the null. Select them both and duplicate. The shortcut to duplicate is Ctrl-D. This round, align the first one with the top of the composition and the last one with the bottom, and as before, spread them along the composition, this time vertically. Also here, we can hide the stroke and leave only the nulls. Now, press P to bring out the position of every null, and we have to split this position into X and Y values. I don't know why, I'm dumb and I did it one by one, but you can select all the position together and do it with just one click. Now we can apply a keyframe on the X position to all the X lines and to the Y position to all the Y lines. Then select everything and press U to have only that property with the keyframe visible. Okay, now the good part. Create a 4-point shape, then select Path and open the panel Create Null from Path. And select Points Follow Nulls. This will generate 4 null objects that control the position of the 4 vertices of our shape. We need to separate the X and Y position properties of all of these shape null, and then parent each position to its corresponding guide null. So, the top left null X position, for example, will be parented to the X1 guide null position, while the Y position will be parented to the Y1 guide null position. We don't need to do it manually for every value, we can just copy the first expression it generates and paste it on the other position property, while changing every time the relative guide null. So, to every position, we paste the expression and edit the name of the null with the one which one control that single point on the grid. With this first shape, all the 4 null objects are correctly parented to the X and Y guides, and they now move independently following these controller nulls. Now we need to apply this same process to all the other boxes, but if we would have to do it one by one, it will take quite some time, so instead we can just work by groups. So let's do a full row of shapes and then generate the controlling nulls. Then apply first the X expression all together to set them horizontally, while only editing the guide number. And then we can do the same with the Y expression to set them vertically on their correct Y guide. I am time-lapsing this part, but it's basically just copy and paste of the same two expression and changing every time the number of the guide that they will have to follow. It may seem a lot of work, but it's just copy and paste. And if you treat it as an assembly line work, you will really speed up the process. But if it's still too much work and you don't want to lose half an hour to set your comp, no shame in that. You can find the template of this grid in the video description. Anyway, now let's bring back on top all of the strokes so that they are above the boxes. I also want to select the shape nulls and switch the show layer off and hide them because we are done with them. And I'm also changing the color of my layer groups. And I also want to change the color of the boxes and the stroke just to have a bit of colors while we test the grid. Now we can keyframe our guide's position and animate them. I'm time-lapsing this part because it's just basic motion of the guide's position with some curves, and that's it. Now we have our dynamic grid. If you wanna know how to go from a basic animation like this to a more interesting and professional result, well, the secret ingredient is having access to a library of high-quality assets like Motion Array. Because when you're a motion designer, it's of incredible help, if not essential, to be able to quickly find and gather visual materials that you can import and use in your project. On Motion Array, you just take a look around, see what you like, download it and drop it in your composition. They not only have motion graphic templates, but also video footage, photo, music, sound effect, graphics and everything you can need. Being a motion designer is not just being good with After Effects, it also means work smart and save time where you can. And Motion Array is a reliable place where you can find these kind of assets that will save you a lot of work. You can try it for free and you'll see how much it will help and even improve your creative life. Also, if you use the link in this video description, you can have $50 off from your annual subscription plan. Now back to the tutorial. Okay, now some variations. If we delete some boxes and we want one box to break the grid to fill an empty space, we just need to edit the expression on its controlling nulls. In this case, the box is the 2/2, so let's just turn on for a moment its shape nulls and simply change the number of the guide that they are following. Now I'm doing the same also for other boxes and changing a bit the colors, but it's obviously the same process. We just need to understand and know our grid. We can do the same also with the stroke parented to the guide. And instead of having the stroke parented to the axis null, we can split its position and parent the X and Y values to the guides that we need. I added to my central box that cool swirly footage from Motion Array and also a couple of masks to create this highlight effect. Now to create a box that follows the guide X and Y, but with some space offset, we use the same process as before and apply the same expression. Once we got it, simply at the end of the expressions, we can simply add a number for how many pixels we want to move our nulls. But before continuing, I need to change a little bit the appearance of the box to better see the result. So let's add some transparency and change the blend mode. Okay, back to the offset. We just need to edit the value of our expression. So keep in mind that the value 0 is on the top left of the composition. So if we want to move a null to the right, we have to add the number of pixels we want. If we want to move it to the left, we have to subtract. Same vertically with the top and bottom. Add to move down and subtract to move up. I want to add some round corner to my square, and we got it. But I also want to change the pink to white and create some blurred transparency effect. If we need to keep any elements aligned to the center of the box, it's quite simple. I'm using a text element, but obviously it works with everything. Okay, again, we separate the X and Y dimensions and then apply this expression that basically say to set the X and Y position values at the split difference between the position of the two guides it is referring. So we just need to change the number of the guides it refers to, so in this case X3 and X4, and the X position of our element will be positioned perfectly between them. And exact same process for the Y position. I want to add some details on our glass and around our text, like some X dot and a couple of strokes that are also controlled by the dynamic grid. Also, I'm setting an inverted matte to hide the stroke behind the text element. A really cool effect to do is to track something to the grid. So let's put some element, again I'm using a text but it can be whatever, and let's pre-compose it. I am going to change the size of this precomp, but you can leave it at full resolution, all depends on your project and what you have to do. Anyway, back to our main comp, let's add to the precomp the effect power pin. But before applying the effect, we need to move the elements to X0 and Y0 position, and then we can apply it. Then to every corner we just need to apply this expression that, like the others, says to follow the X and Y guides. We just need to change the number of the guides that we want it to follow. It may seem it's not working, but don't worry, keep adding the expression to all the corners. Now the corners are parented to the guides, but as you can see, the position is off. To fix this, we just need to edit the expression to add at the end a value that is half of the precomp dimension. For example, my precomp is 700x and 500y, so I will add the half of that. In my case, it is 350 on the x and 250 on the y. As you can see, the distortion gets corrected and tracked to the intersection of the axis. I'm not very good at math, probably exists a better way, maybe by just setting this half of the comp size as a starting position of our element, I don't know, but it works the same. Anyway, now our precomp is tracked to the grid and gets stretched according to the movement of the guides. But according to my former graphic design professor, apparently we are not allowed to stretch fonts, so I have a last thing for you. I'm doing this with text, but it can be done with anything that can be converted into a shape element, so even icons or illustration. So convert your element into a shape, then again open your panel Create Nulls from Path, select all the paths and click Point Follow Nulls. Now we have all of the nulls that control our text or shape. We need to create some new main nulls, to which we have to parent all of these shape nulls. This is to protect the element's proportions. Since my element is a text, I just need three main nulls. One for the proportion of the top of the text, one for the bottom, and one for the middle. So we select all the shape nulls and isolate them to see better what's happening. Now we just need to select all the shape nulls from the area we want to protect and parent them to the to that area main null, and then we can turn them off. Same thing with the nulls from the lower part of the text. Bring them down, parent them to the bottom main null, and then turn them off. And oops, I also forgot the mid null, here we go. As you can see, the top and bottom part of our text elements are now protected from distortion and follow the position of the top and bottom's main nulls. We can do the same also with the null from the center. Now we can treat these three null as everything else we have seen in this tutorial. So let's split their dimension in X and Y, and we can parent them to the guide of the grid. Since in this text the distortion happens only vertically, I am parenting to the grid guide only the Y value of the top and bottom nulls. And I'm also adding an offset of 50 pixels. To the Y position of the mid null, I'm going to apply the expression we've seen before that keeps them in the middle of the box. I'll use the same expression on all the X position, so that vertically it stretches, but horizontally always stays in the middle of the box. So, thanks for watching, remember to subscribe to the channel and don't be scared by the amount of null objects you'll end up with. You can download the template, but my advice is to set it up yourself, because you'll have a better grasp of how it works and what's happening. Also, if you want to improve your work and save a ton of hours on your next project, take a look at Motion Array. And don't forget, you can get $50 off from your annual plan. You can find them in the link in the description. Let me know in the comments if there's some topic you would like to see a video about, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye!